Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
The truth is proudly brought to you by the IBFP, aka the Fanboy Killer. Gervonta Tank Davis Fanboys Exposed, and we start with the first idiot in Fanboy, and it's a guy whose name I can't even pronounce because it looks like his mama fell asleep on a keyboard when she named this clown. And his comment is this in relation to Tank Davis fighting Mario Barrios. He came out and stated, "Sounds like a brown, bitter boy about to burst a neck vein over his feelings. Anytime a black warrior beats a Mexican, that Mexican immediately turns into some blue-collar worker. More reason for you brown boys to fear that black fist." Now, this guy is clearly an idiot and in his feelings, because we're going to break this down with nothing but facts. If Mario Barrios wasn't a cherry pick and he was a killer at 140 pounds, then why does he have zero elite wins? Why does he have a controversial fight against a guy with only 7 career fights? Explain that. Does that make you elite? Does that make you dangerous? Make it make sense. This is a guy who arguably already lost to somebody and got a robbery gift decision against a dude with only 7 career fights. And this is the killer that Tank Davis was fighting? Was Mario Barrios even a world champion? Hell no, because Josh Taylor holds all the belts at 140 pounds. This guy uses race to defend cherry picking while I use facts to expose the truth. I mean, look at his picture. Look at this guy's picture. This is how you know this guy's a fanboy. What man takes a picture facing a wall like this? This looked like Tank Davis is about to blow his asshole out. Let's be honest. The next idiot is only one doobie, and he states, y'all just will not give Tank Davis his credit. Give this man his credit for what? Beating a guy who's accomplished nothing at 140 pounds? Who wasn't a world champion? This win is something special to you? This is your king? This is a great win for you? This guy's delusional. He needs to be concerned about where he left his neck. But let's keep it going. And the next one is from Juvenile, and he states, you know, how was Barrios a cherry pick? He had a belt. Stop being biased. No, you moron. Josh Taylor has all the belts at 140 pounds. This guy had a McDonald's belt. He get that in a kid's meal. Let's be honest and unbiased. And the next one comes from Backdoor Benny. I don't even want to start where this guy named, you know, and he states, you know, so Canelo fights Smith and that's not a cherry pick. Question mark, you clown? Wait a minute. So you're saying that Canelo Alvarez cherry-picked Callum Smith? Callum Smith was an undefeated world champion, also was a ring champion and the World Boxing Super Series winner. He was also the most accomplished fighter and the number one rated fighter in the division. You're comparing an elite fighter like Callum Smith, who was the best at 168, to a guy in Mario Barrios who wasn't even a champion? The guy who got a belt from a kid's meal? Are you serious? You gotta be an idiot. These fanboys get dumber by the day. I mean, look at this guy. His name is Backdoor Benny. Now I know why his name is Backdoor Benny, because all of his comments are ass. Let's keep it going. And the next one comes from Africa Queen. And Africa Queen states, anytime I come to this page as a non-American, I get the impression of hatred by non-black Latino towards African American and other black fighters. I hope this isn't how the world is. Imagine the kind of hatred someone like you has for someone who gets a victory, and it angers you so much you wish for their demise so you can bathe in their failure. First of all, and this is from Africa Queen, this idiot is a moron, idiot, and a dummy. First of all, I would never wish for anyone's demise. I simply want the best to fight the best. This is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. We use facts and never race to prove a point on this channel. And just to, you know, debunk this clown, we called Anthony Joshua the best heavyweight in the division time and time again, and yet we hate black fighters. Is Anthony Joshua not black? We called Errol Spence the truth after beating a Latino fighter. And is Errol Spence not black? Is there something I'm missing? See, I know why you're biased. You call yourself African Queen, but with all that makeup on your face, you look more like a drag queen. Let's keep it going. And the next one comes from Trav202. And his only comment on a video of mine about Tank Davis and Mario Barrios, this guy says, show your face, bro. This guy doesn't even leave a comment or a question about boxing. His only request is to see a man's face. So you come to this channel to look at men? This dude sounds like he wants to go play hide the churro. Because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.